Hey, James Weatherly with JTW Pilot Channel with our feature link story about the water bombers. Wow, you're going to love this. Hey, to back up real quick, how this got started, I was making a trip to Churchill, Manitoba to see some polar bears. Our first stop to clear customs was in Winnipeg. When my airplane pulled up there and I shut down the engines, I looked out in the distance and saw these awesome water bombers. I had always wanted to see them up close. It brought back memories in my mind of these gorgeous pictures of water bombers coming in for landings and skimming across to scoop up the water and then drop it on the fire. Well, I'm in a foreign airport. I can't just walk across to see them. So I went back, talked to the beautiful people at the Kelly Western FBO. They organized an escort for me, took me for an up-close tour of this squadron of CL-215s. That's the older version with the round engines. Oh, it was a joy to actually be in the presence of these airplanes. And this is what brought me to making this video for you. The first thing we'll look at is the great CL-215 radial engine. Listen to this engine start. It's awesome. Sorry, I know that's a little loud on the ears, but I used to fly these radial engines. They are that loud. The next thing was the modified turboprop version, the 215T and the 415. Listen to these awesome turbines starting. Hey, enough of me talking. We got this thing started. Let's crank the music up and take it for a spin. Here we go. Ouch, that's tough. We're right in the middle of rocking along and we stop. But don't forget, these are fire trucks in the sky coming to put out fires. Let's learn a little bit about them. Hey, this whole thing was based on the great PBY Catalina, and production of these aircraft started in 1968 specifically for aerial firefighting. So successful in the original run, 125 airplanes were built with this 2100 shaft horsepower radial engine. 1,400 gallons of water they could take up. A simple thing. Hey, you'd come up for a nice low approach about 50 feet off the ground, skim along for a couple of thousand feet, then climb back out, and the total distance was no more than one statute mile. What an amazing concept. You got water, we'll take it to the fire. Notice this pilot as he comes in for a nice smooth landing. He comes in for a great touchdown, but the difference between a normal airplane, as soon as he touched down, look, he adds full power because he's going to ride along skimming, filling those tanks. Once they're full, he gets the airspeed, lifts off, and up and away he goes. So back in the back behind him, there's these two sets of huge tanks that are filling up with water, depending on 1,400, 1,600 gallons, and they can even add some fire retardant and chemicals in it. Then they fly it right to the fire, open the doors, and kaboom! Here comes this water, putting it out. It's really awesome. Now, on the 215, they had kind of a steam-powered cockpit, ones that those of us knew from a long time ago. But then they eventually upgraded things. They made the 215T and the 415. This was the turbine version. They made 75 of these, and they had the slightly larger Pratt & Whitney turbine engines, could hold 200 extra gallons for 1,600, and most importantly, they added, instead of a two bomb bay door, there was a four so they could dump it in a hurry. And the cockpit kind of looked like the 757 I used to fly. Sort of a half glass, more modern cockpit, especially compared to the ones with the round engines. So that made it a lot nicer for pilots. The next big upgrade, once again, was those four-door, two on each side bomb bays that would just let that water come ripping out of there. Hey, enough of me talking about these cool things. Let's crank up the music and watch them fly.